got to only jeans to want. One on my own. Only car to want. Cash a good job.
Yeah, welcome you all once again to here, you know, Chris Vlog, and you know how we do it. This is another video reaction for Kiss Daniel's song entitled Twitter Remix. You know, he did a song with Davido, and to the best of my knowledge, this song was shot by TJ Omori, and TJ Omori is one of the best cinematographers in Nigeria. I would say an expensive one at that, very expensive, if not the most expensive in Nigeria. Every A-class artist want to use him, you know, for their video and visuals. So yeah, basically he did this video, and all his videos are rich in colors and varieties and deep stories. You have to have good music intellect to be able to decipher his stories and videos. And yeah, that being said, yeah, let's dive into this one. But yeah, I want to urge you all who yet to subscribe, if you're yet to subscribe, please run to the subscription button now and click it. Don't run, just push your hand to the right side and click it. And if you yet to click on the notification bell, what are you waiting for? You know, be the first to know whenever I drop a new content. Please click on that one so you'll definitely be notified whenever there's a new content. Then if you're yet to share my video to friends, well wishes and loved ones, please just do that, because it actually do help my algorithm, you know, to grow. And when my algorithm grows, what does it do? It helps my video to be out there in more faces. So please help me, endeavor to help a brother. This is how you motivate me. Doing this is just all you can do for me. And endeavor to also like this video. Like it right now. I mean, because if you wait till the end, you might get carried away. So that being said, let's jump into this video. So yeah, remember he featured the video on this song, I mean Kiss Daniel. And yeah, the video started with, you know, the Flyboy logo and the Empire logo. And yeah, I'm watching the video right here, so I'm deciphering and dissecting it from this point. So yeah, from time to time, my eye will go to the camera. So yeah, so the video started with an animation, cartoonish kind of vibe. And that will get you thinking, wow, is it a cartoon video? But if you look deep well into the animation in a kind of still motion, you will understand, like, the pictures there are the people who are like the cast or crew of this video. It's more to that, but yeah, most of them, yeah. So being that I've watched this video, I'll be a little bit ahead, you know, with my story. So if you have listened to the audio of this song and you're conversant with the lyrics, if you're yet to listen to it, please click on the link above here. You can go listen to me analyzing the audio lyrics of the song. So the audio in summary was trying to say the situation of the country is bad, and this person was actually talking to a lady, and this person was Kiss Daniel. And Kiss Daniel was telling the lady that, you know, no matter how bad the situation is, he's got cars, he's got, you know, good house, making family is hard, but for him it's not a difficult thing. You know, he's got so much money, but he's got no lady, no companion, you know. Pelu, zero shorty. I remember that line. So Kiss Daniel was trying to make the impression on that audio version of the song that I missed him liking a good life. He's on his first bottle, second bottle, and the third bottle is coming. You know, he wants a girl, and the girl he wants must know how to twerk. So that was what he was telling the girl in the first verse. For the girl to twerk, to know if he's going to choose the girl to be his own. So it seems like he has a fantasy that his woman, his lady, his significant half, will definitely know how to twerk the ass. And that's what this video actually made me know on what I already know about the audio song. So yeah, you know, like, you know, movies, as the actors and actresses take on a foreign character, a character that's not them, that's how music do take characters. So the person wearing Kiss Daniel's character here now is this old man. He's an OG. So the beginning of the song gave a vibe of, you know, this OG, you know, he has the spirit of a teenager in him. He likes life, you know, he likes to party. So he's given a vibe of he, like, just finished serving, you know, as a civil servant, or, you know, you just called it a day to retirement. Maybe he was a businessman, maybe he was a politician or what have you. So probably he just, you know, finished, you know, his service days as a worker or a civil servant. So he called for party, family party. So showing this chubby guy here right now this is just showing that even as the country is hard, he had enough to like feed this chubby guy who likes food. So he's got enough that goes around the people around him, even this chubby guy that eats a lot. Do you understand? So that's the metaphorical concept of this part. So that's why this guy is here, to show you like this man has got enough to feed this, you know, chubby guy. You can see him now, you know, he invited so many people to that party. You know, probably he's like I said, he's going into retirement and to receive pensions for the rest of his life. What a good life. And yeah, he's not doing as if he's got a wife. No vibe of wife, you know. You see a lady there, but the lady was acting like a church member or sister or a relation, you know. But the guy still has this young teenager fire in him. Him getting into this party mood, you know. They showed his bedroom where he had like a whole lot of shorties. You know, Pelu, four shorties, four girls dancing, twerking their body, right? And this will tell you the man has varieties, you know. He's got a whole lot of, you know, acquaintance, you know, with girls. This is what is metaphorically telling you. Like, in his coffers, in his room, in his closet, he's got, you know, he knows ladies he's going to call and they'll be there for him, you know. But he needs one, you know, to be a lifetime companion. So, yeah, and this shows a lady now who's walking into a room with a banging body, like, you know, good shape, good features. And Kiss Daniel now came into the court and, you know, doing his thing. So he can't be playing the character and singing. So he chose to sing and let that OG as a man play the character he was singing on the song. So the man was, you know, here trying to welcome more guests. And all of a sudden, you see chickens flying in. So what's those chicken flying in? Do you have an idea of what that means? Do any of you know why they infuse that into those visuals? I'll tell you. So that chicken is a metaphorical kind of line. That chicken is like his main chick, his side chick, his whatever chick. So they came into the party uninvited. They crashing the party, do you understand? So they came where the family are and everything. So he was distressed. If you see his face here, he's like, what are you guys doing here, you know? So that's his secret life. He has like a life like he doesn't want to put in the midst of his family. You can see these ladies are twerking in his room. He's in the sitting room with families, with friends, you know. He doesn't want to show them that his freaky side of, you know, living a freaky lifestyle. Like, he's got it in him like a teenager. So these chickens, they flew in and everyone was trying to chase them away, you know, probably because of their attitude or what have you. So probably those chickens represent metaphorically his side chicks and main chick or whatever. So remember, this man doesn't have a main lady, so they probably are his side chick and, you know, somehow they came to the party, caused a chaos and they're leaving. So that's why they flew out and the chubby guy was busy chasing on them, probably because he likes one of them or, you know, who knows. So that being said, you know, he still shows you the kitchen where there's a whole lot of food and what have you. So the man is an OG, like, believe me, he's a legend when it comes to, you know, women affairs, you know. So yeah, after that, they showed you a book that, you know, its page got flipped. And what that showed you that Kiss Daniel's verse has come to an end visually and, you know, storytelling wise. So the OG line has come to an end, because if you listen to Kiss Daniel's part and Davido's part, it's too abstract topic they're talking. Kiss Daniel is like a man chasing or looking out for love. He's got so much money. And at the end of the day, he wants his lady to embody the act or craft of knowing how to twerk her ass. But Davido in the song was singing about the ladies he's encountering. He's been beautiful and they've made him miscalculate. They've made him, you know, start to go keke na pepe, you know, or Sunday or Wendy. His lifestyle is kind of, you know, making some people like him more and making some people dislike him. So if you look into these two topics, they're abstract from each other, but let's see visually what Davido's interpretation of this song brought to us on this video. So it started with that same lady, you know, moving, and her bosom, my God, is massive. And where Davido was singing has this Egyptian Coptic symbols. And you can tell they made it in the look Egyptian and ancient, rather. So good dress, you know, it matched with the world, the concept. And ladies twerking their asses and what have you. And this girl with an Egyptian costume, like I told you before, the wall was painted with, you know, that Egyptian concept, right? That Egyptian symbol is behind Davido in that wars, right? It epitomizes that Davido wasn't actually only saying or referring to Nigerian ladies when he was trying to talk about ladies making him, you know, go crazy, kenapepe, and make him miscalculate or what have you. Because he kind of pluralized it at a point when he said, with the way them mean so many of them, twerk, fito make a man, you know, go crazy. And that means the African ladies, or that means the black race. Because, yeah, this video kind of showed you he's not talking to only one race. Like you can see, at a point, there was a lady on an African Egyptian costume. At a point, you see black ladies in a kind of corporate style, choir style, native style, contemporary native African style. You see them all dancing. And what does that tell you? He's trying to say, like, these girls, this black race, they are beautiful. Wherever you find yourself, whether you're a black American, wherever, they are very, very beautiful. But, you know, the dance they were dancing there still was an African kind of dance, you know. So basically, this song was actually a very good song. As you can see here, yeah, they're dancing. And the message this video was trying to pass was like, African ladies, you guys are beautiful. No matter where you are in the world, you guys are very beautiful. And remember, before you are a black American, before you are from anywhere, just like Bonaboy mother said, you are an African first, and nobody can take that away. If they trace your origin, it's a must, it be traced back to African. And that's what Davido was trying to say with his verse. So that being said, I will say, like, this is where this reaction video comes to an end. Please subscribe if you're yet to subscribe. Share this video. And my next video will be me analyzing a song from Mojo Black. And for those of you who hear him rap and pidgin English and don't know what he say, I'm gonna analyze his video as a next video. So that being said, please love yourself like you ought to love yourself. Peace, and see you in the next video.
Isakaba, give me your bagasi. Your body looking like tsunami. Explosive Hiroshima Nagasaki. Let me amage, don't make me miscalculate. Don't make me overdepe. Don't make me the misbehave. Me the way them twerk. We don't make a man go. Take it now, pepe. Egg by me, oh Jesus. Baby feeling the boy like Oleku. Asan di o wey, di o di o di o di o. Oya si di wey a body twerk. Your body twerk. Baby take your body twerk. Twerk your body twerk. And the way, and the way that twerk. Twerk your body twerk. Twerk your body twerk.
Shout out my list.